So Nina Turner went on CNN, and a surrogate from the Biden campaign, who is a total Karen, if you know what a Karen is, tried to whitesplain Martin Luther King to her. This is outrageous. Take a look.
But it's how Biden deals with it. You said you were arrested when you were with Mandela. I don't think so. You say that you were trained to be a protester and suffered. We don't think so. How do you deal with the record of votes and of stories that don't hold up?
You know, Nina referenced Dr. Martin Luther King before, saying that he said from the Birmingham jail that we should be concerned about white moderates. That's actually not what Martin Luther King said. What he said is we should be worried about the silence of white moderates.
Are you kidding me?
Nina, wait.
No, she's making a language point.
What he said was we should worry about the silence of white moderates. And what we have in Joe Biden is a man who is not silent. He has a long record, and many, many votes that in today's world feel like the wrong thing were the wrong thing, and he has discussed that over and over again, as Bernie Sanders did on the gun votes and other things. So we can be talking about votes from 20 years ago, or we can be talking about people's values and who they trust.
Last quick point.
And that's what Joe Biden's going to be talking
about. Last quick point to you, Nina.
With the Reverend... Chris, what Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was talking about, he said it is the point that the white moderate wants things to be comfortable, and instead of focusing in on that, the bigger threat is not necessarily the white KKK member, but more the white moderate that is more comfortable with keeping things the same and pretending like there is no tension.
Don't use Martin Luther King against Joe Biden. You don't have that. You don't have that standing.
First of all,
I'm sorry.
You
don't.
Don't tell me what kind of standing I have as a black woman in America. How dare you?
You have a lot of standing as a black woman in America. You don't have the standing to attack Joe Biden using Martin Luther King's words.
I didn't attack anybody. You're taking it that way. Listen, don't dip into what I have to say about the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. How dare you, white woman, sit up here and try to tell me
what I'm
supposed to feel and what I'm doing right
now. I'm out of time on this.
I didn't jump in on her, and then she wants to jump in on me.
Okay,
and
first of all, it's not nobody jumping in on anybody. You guys are in the same party. This is what you guys have to figure out. You're in the same party. And let me tell you, you better keep that same energy when you're up against Trump that you have against each other, because he is bigger and badder than I think you guys are ready for. But let's agree on this about Dr. King. Only light can drive out darkness.
This is absolutely outrageous. This makes my blood boil. Not only did that scumbag, that racist, talk over Nina Turner and try to tone police her and whitesplain her, but Chris Cuomo does nothing. He just lets her continue. He doesn't intervene. And notice how before he was like, Nina, hold on, let her talk. But when she talks over Nina, that's fine. This is absolutely outrageous. How dare you come on national television and lecture a black woman, Nina Turner, a senator no less, about Martin Luther King? You don't know the last goddamn thing about Martin Luther King. And on the point of the white moderate, he's literally talking about you. He's literally talking about Joe Biden, the man you're here to defend. He openly lies about being arrested trying to meet Nelson Mandela. He lies about having taken part in the civil rights movement. The guy was working with segregationists. Meanwhile, Martin Luther King was trying to fight them. He orchestrated the crime bill that put millions of people in jail, and the majority of them blacks and people of color. His entire career, he's been enabling and propping up this establishment, this system that does nothing but oppress working class people, and especially blacks and people of color. And now you're going to come on the air and lecture Nina Turner, you disgusting scumbag, enabling that cocksucker Joe Biden? How fucking dare you? You are exactly the person that Martin Luther King warned us about. You are the embodiment of the white moderate. That's you. And I'm going to read you the quote from Martin Luther King and pay very, very close attention. Because what that Karen did is not what Martin Luther King said. Pay attention. He says, the Negro's great stumbling block is not the white citizen's counselor or the Ku Klux Klan, but the white moderate who is more devoted to order than to justice, who prefers a negative peace, which is the absence of tension, to a positive peace, which is the presence of justice, who constantly says, I agree with you in the goal you seek, but I can't agree with your methods of direct action. And that's what we always hear. That's what they always use to silence criticism. I want to help you. I agree with you. But I can't implement systemic reform. That's going too far. That's what we hear about everything. Universal healthcare coverage? No, that's going too far. $15 minimum wage? I agree with you, people deserve a living wage, but that's going too far. Anything to prevent systemic reform, and that is Joe Biden, that's his goal. What did he say to his private fundraisers? Nothing would fundamentally change. This entire system is built to serve corporations. And who does Joe Biden work for? Who are his donors? The corporations. He is an agent of the establishment. He is an enabler of this systemic racism and oppression. And who gets hurt the most by the status quo? Not just the working class, especially black people. You know black women die at 3 times the rate because of childbirth complications? You know how big the wealth gap is between the 1% and the rest? It's even bigger for blacks and minorities. A black woman earns less than anybody on the dollar in America. Who helped to prop that system up? When Joe Biden was vice president, what did he do about police shootings, about mass incarceration? Nothing. He pretends to be on the side of minorities and blacks, but he actively works against them because he is maintaining the system that oppresses those very people. He is an agent of that system. He is the white moderate. And then you want to come and lecture Nina Turner? You piece of shit. She is an amazing person. She is a true progressive. She's my sister of color, and I stand in solidarity with her on everything because she really believes in what she fights for. She knows that the system is designed to oppress working class people, and especially blacks and people of color. How dare you silence her about that? You fucking neoliberal garbage. You establishment hack. When Hillary Clinton was interrupted by that girl from Black Lives Matter, she told security to cart her away. When Bernie Sanders was interrupted by Black Lives Matter, he said, "The podium is yours. Speak your mind, speak your heart." That's the difference. When Joe Biden was working to protect states' rights so they can continue their oppression of black people, continue to not adopt busing, guess what Bernie Sanders was doing? Bernie Sanders was protesting segregation. Bernie Sanders was arrested, chained to a black woman, protesting what Joe Biden was trying to maintain. And this garbage surrogate of his is now going to come on the air and not just defend that disgusting record, but invoke the memory of Martin Luther King to do it as well, adding insult to injury. And then this woman, the surrogate from Biden, Hillary Rosen, she issues an apology and talks about angry black women, this whole stereotype of angry black women. And honestly, I don't think you can even call this an apology. It's just more racism. She can't stop. Look what she says. "On air Thursday, I said my colleague Nina Turner didn't have standing to use Martin Luther King Jr. That was wrong. I'm sorry for saying those words. Please, no need to defend me and attack angry black women. They have standing. I always need to listen more than I talk." So she's using that cliche stereotype of angry black women. Like, she just can't stop with the racism. This is nonsense. Just like she insulted Nina Turner and talked over her and whitesplained to her on national TV, she should go back on national TV and apologize to Nina Turner properly in front of the nation. And Bernie Sanders also had something to say about this. "Joe Biden must accept responsibility for his surrogate telling our campaign co-chair, Senator Nina Turner, that she doesn't have standing to invoke the words of Dr. King. That is unacceptable, and Joe must apologize to Nina and all the people of color supporting our campaign." Damn right. Because just like the mainstream media whine about online Bernie bros, and Bernie Sanders has to always apologize over and over again for people he doesn't even know and has no responsibility over. If you remember, they even made Bernie Sanders apologize over this article in The Guardian by Zafir Teachout that listed all of Joe Biden's corruption, how he takes money from the healthcare industry, the credit card industry. It was an amazing article, and he never should have apologized for it. He should have been using it to point out Joe Biden's corruption. Now, Joe Biden must also apologize for this. But of course, there's been no word from Joe Biden, no word from his campaign, and nothing on the mainstream media. This is the double standard. Let me show you what Nina Turner had to say about that afterwards.
"The stereotypes about black women, you know, and these are generational stereotypes, especially the one that calls us angry, it bothers me, it burns my behind. Yes, I've been stereotyped, I've been maligned, I've been called an Aunt Jemima. I mean, this is a PG, so I'm gonna keep it PG, but it really does get to me a lot. We carry lots of burdens on our back. Black women are mad, we are angry, and I'm not ashamed. I embrace it, I'm leaning into it. Yes, angry black women unite. We are mad as hell about a whole bunch of stuff, and we need other people to join us. We are taking applications. You can be an angry black woman too." I mean, if people are not mad about what is going on in this country right now and even this world, and something is wrong. So I lean into that. It is sad because people try to use that against us. But yeah, no, we're mad as hell, and we have a right to be mad as hell.
Amen. People are mad. People should be mad. Just like the rant that I did yesterday. How can you not be mad? They want to silence you and gaslight you and invalidate your feelings and your struggles. That's what they do to silence criticism and keep people in line. And we can't let them do that. And like I said, as my sister of color, I stand in solidarity with her. I stand in solidarity with the struggles that Black people face in America, because this oppression is carried out worldwide. This war on drugs, this mass incarceration of Blacks, this shooting of unarmed Black civilians. Those same people who are maintaining that system come and bomb my country, come and destroy my country in the name of democracy. The white moderate, the two-faced neoliberal. Oh yeah, I'm for racial equality, but I'm going to keep maintaining the prison industrial complex, the corrupt justice system, the corrupt police departments. I'm going to hold nobody accountable. Oh yeah, I'm for democracy, so I'm going to come and drone strike your family. I'm going to come and destroy your country. I'm going to come and level cities in your country. This is exactly what Martin Luther King warned us about. The two-faced white moderate, who is always going to claim to be on your side, but always resist systemic reform. Why? Because they are the system. They represent the status quo, the establishment, the 1%. And goddamn you if you talk over Nina Turner again, you racist piece of shit.